Hi, I'm Josh Milheim. I'm a product manager at Domo, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a custom branded landing page for your company using the new Stories feature. Prior to creating my landing page, I went through and I mocked up more or less what I want my page to look like. I created a background image with a gradient so that my text shows well on the left side, and then created some icons to serve as links as my users come to this page to self-select into the departments that they are interested in and see metrics related to those specific departments. So the first thing that I'll do is I'll start on a blank page. We'll edit the story, and I want to add my background image first. So we'll come here, we'll choose image fill, choose image, and our landing page background. With my background in place now, I'm going to start dragging in these frames that are going to make up the bulk of my layout. So we'll create a skeleton first and then refine as we go. So I know I wanted my header section here. I wanted to split the lower part into kind of two main sections. This is going to be my CEO quote area. And then over here will be my 2x3 section for tiles or buttons for each of the different departments. I don't have to get this exact just yet because I will come back and edit this. I also wanted to add a header here. Find the report that matters to you. So again, we'll come back and we'll clean this up, but for now, we have our bones in place and we're good to continue. First thing I'm going to do is I want to use one of the text boxes so that I can insert my company logo at the top of this page. I'll do that by going to the image uploader and importing my PNG. This may look funny until I come and change the background color. In this case, I want no fill. Now I can see my PNG and we'll just resize from there. Next, I want to add my CEO quote. So we'll come here again, we'll insert text, and I will paste in my CEO quote. I want this to be a little bit larger. So let's go ahead and make that the subtitle size. And we're going to again change the background to be no fill. I can do this because with the page level background, I intentionally added this gradient on the left side so that my text would show up. Next, we wanted to add our CEO's image and her name and title. And I'm going to do that by breaking this card into a smaller subsection. So I'll come here. Let's add a card. It's going to be a little smaller than that. And add this here. I want these two boxes to be as small as they can be. So I'll resize that down just a touch. We are going to, again, insert text, and similar to what we did with the page header here, we're going to insert another image, which will be a PNG of my CEO. All right. And again, we'll change the background to be no fill. We'll resize this later. And then here, I want to add her name and title. My top line, I want to make really large. Bold. And I want to change this to match my company colors. So I'll insert the hex value for my company and then change the text size. So the text is wrapping differently than I want it to. I can play with this a little bit by manipulating the background of the card. When I have a card background, in this case there's a white background, it adds a little bit of padding around the edges. So I'm going to come here, change the background to be no fill. Notice that I now get more of that space and can kind of go full bleed edge to edge with my text. I also want to change the alignment options on our card. Then I think this image is a little bit too big, so we'll scale that down just a touch. And again, we can change the alignment options. So I can always hit save and kind of see what our progress looks like so far. So far, I think that is matching our mock pretty closely. So let's continue. Next step is going to be to build out each of these tiles. Again, I'm going to insert text. And for each section, I'm going to add a department title. We'll make them bold. Space a couple times. And then I'm going to insert my icons. So again, I created these icons ahead of time. And again, we're probably going to want to resize these just a bit. So my icons weren't made for a white background, so I'll need to change the background. In this case, I want to use my company gray. Okay. For my image, I did want it to be centered, so I'll change my alignment options there. I'll repeat this process for each of these different tiles here, and then we can come back and wire up the interactions that will send me to a different page when I click on them. Now I have all of my tiles in place. I've done some tweaking of the size. Now that everything is kind of closer to a finished version, I want to make sure that my sizing is all correct and everything lines up. Looks pretty good. But let's go ahead and save just to see our progress. This looks just about done. The last part is connecting each of these tiles to their corresponding dashboards. To do that, we'll go back into edit mode. And then for each dashboard, we'll come to edit content, change interaction, and then link to anything in Domo. We'll choose our sales dashboard. And then do the same thing for each of my tiles. Now that I've wired up each of my tiles to the corresponding department level dashboards, the last remaining step would be for me to go into the admin section and set my landing page to be the company level landing page. So this was just one way to create a landing page. There's many ways, so play with it. And if you have any questions or feedback while using Domo Stories, please reach out to product.feedback@domo.com or using the in-product feedback link in the page header. Thanks.